So we focus a little bit more at, well, we focus more attention on assessing people's symptoms during the second week of illness. We've come to recognize, and this is not a surprise having lived through SARS a number of years ago, but people who have apparently a mild illness early on, it's a critical period of time around day five, day six, day seven, where they either start to really get better and shrug it off, or some people can very quickly go downhill. And that is a critical period of time where we're having more contact with people. We're making sure that if they are having any experience of shortness of breath or chest pain or other things that might come with having an infection that affects both the lungs and other parts of the body, that they are, we have a low threshold for bringing them into hospital, at least for observation, where they can be closer to critical care if needed. So that's one of the things. The other one is we're making sure our algorithms for who can safely recover at home cover things like, you know, we've always known that as you get older, your chances of having a more severe illness go up, but also covering things like people who have underlying illnesses that might make them at more risk, and making sure that we have ongoing connections to make sure that if there's any concern at all that somebody might be not getting better or have concerns that they call 811, that we have the ability to get them into a facility much quicker just in case.